afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Today is March 11th, 2004.
That's correct.
And we are, need to ask you some questions about some of the latest news we're hearing about.
We're only 14 or 15 days away from the sentence of the 26th.
Right.
Right, so go ahead.
I was calling because I heard that they were going to be trying to close the transcripts of the minutes to the trial.
That's correct.
What is that about?
Well, actually, you see what happened is, first of all, they had to close the trial from the public so that no one would see what was going on in the courtroom. Right? And then when Mr. Wood and Seals was on television and people started calling in, asking about the evidence and about the witnesses, on the internet, their witnesses wasn't real victims, but just FBI agents and GBI and sheriff's people and et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Right? Their backs became against the wall because they couldn't answer. And so, imagine Wood said, you must have been in a different court than I am. So he realized at that point, these people are waiting for the transcripts or the minutes so that the public can put it up. And so, now they knew he was waiting to get the transcripts. The transcripts we needed was A, the ones pre-trial, where the judge was making most of the biased statements, making covering up for the prosecution, assisting the prosecution, and making outright derogatory statements against myself, where he took away my constitutional rights because he wouldn't give me a continuance when he knew I just got a new attorney, Adrian Patrick's, a brand new attorney. He knew I just got him, and this man couldn't have enough time in 6 days to get the case together, and as I said earlier, and the prosecution had it for 2 years. So he, working with them, immediately said no, left this young man to work by himself, you follow? Mm-hmm. Wouldn't even let anybody assist him in the court when he asked, well, can I get somebody behind me to have a whole bunch of boxes, because the Darling firm gave me 37 boxes and stuff that ain't nobody been able, they haven't even went to my dust on me. Can I get someone to come in the court, work behind me? He was told no. Meanwhile, the judge, Ashley Wells, allowed the prosecution to have Jelaine Warden, who's a part of the state case, you follow?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Then they have Thatcher from Washington, D.C. Then they had another woman, I forgot her name, Tracy Bowen, right? But they had all of them there, and they was allowed to run in and out of the court and assist Maxwell Wood, Moultrie, and Thatcher, giving them five other people sitting behind them with the press leaning over their shoulders.
Mm.
You follow? So they can assist them. So what happened is, the truth is now starting to come out, like they say. The chickens are coming home to roost.
Right.
As they would put it. Now they're beginning to see them realize that we ain't waiting to get the transcripts. They also realize we have specialists that are on it. NLPA?
Yes.
Out of Cincinnati. And they're on the case. And their people dissected the so-called PSI and saw all kind of mistakes and heights and upward departures and stuff that shouldn't be there. Right? Now we got some special lawyers out of New York that are working. And we got another lawyer out of Savannah that are working. So they now know we're going to have people going through these minutes with a fine-tooth comb.
Right.
And each transcript and find every contradiction and every mistake that they make. You follow? So what they're doing now is telling people, not only could you not see the truth in court, but now we don't even want you to hear the truth in court. We're going to block the minutes because they know each, as we get a transcript, we're going to put that transcript up on the internet for everybody to see what people said while on the stand, how they was cross-examined. They went as far as saying they want to knock down their own experts, not just our experts, but their own experts. They're actually trying to block their own experts.
Mm-hmm.
Because they had a situation that came up in the court case where they were saying none of the kids that they claimed was being sexually abused all these years had any physical damage.
Mm-hmm.
So they had to bring in lying experts who could say you can have no physical damage being raped from 7, 8, 9, and 10 years old all your life for how many years is that? For almost
five,
10, 15 years of being raped on a daily basis, according to their own statement, 2 or 3 times a day, 4 or 5 times a day,
mm-hmm.
and have no scars. And the prosecution, Mr. Wood, made that a major point. It doesn't matter if you have no scars, because whether you come up normal or not, then you're still, you can be normal with no scars and no trace of scars, and no keloiding, no nothing, no damage, and have been molested, or you can't. Then later on, when Mr. Moultrie started to close his argument, he made a point to dig in on one subject, saying one of the people there had a scar.
Mm-hmm.
And all of a sudden, one scar pops up as very important. They know that's going to pop up in the minutes. They know their experts made all kinds of mistakes. They know the agents they put on the stand, like Jelaine Ward, reaffirmed that there was never anyone that told her I ever transported anybody across the state line for anything, especially sexually.
Mm-hmm.
Right? They knew that the mothers got on the stand and said, I took my daughter or my son across the state line. He ain't had nothing to do with it. We didn't even live in Putnam County when he was living there. And then no people got on the stand and said, Malachi didn't live in Putnam County during this whole period of time. He ain't been over here for 2 years. They see all of that. They see the mistakes. They see the errors the judge made when the judge was making poor decisions. He was making emotional decisions. And he was being arrogant and being racist all at the same time. Then it came out what's going on in Gwinn County, Brunswick, you can go to our webpage and patch in, and you see in Brunswick, they have down there what they call corrupt jury pools.
Right.
People have been brought, people have been paid, people have been threatened and put on that jury pool so they can control them. But, so what they try to do is they want to lock down the jury deliberation when the judge was picking the jurors.
Right.
They have to lock that down because they're making statements that nobody heard about this case, and he puts his life on the line and his career on the line, and then come to find out every jury that walks in the room says, yes, I heard about the case, heard it from the Brunswick News. The Brunswick News was sponsored by, I think it was done by Seals. Seals was one who was responsible for the Brunswick News knowing, because he called down and spoke on the telephone and had it in the paper before the trial, before the pre-trial, and before the parade.
Right.
So they had already spoiled it, but the judge had to move on because he was under orders to do it. You follow? So in actuality, yeah, what you're saying is true. We have a situation now where they're going to really try to deceive the public because they don't want nobody to hear what went on in court. So first they made it so no one can see what went on in court. Right?
Right.
And now they're making it so no one will hear. You know, they see no evil, hear no evil.
Right.
And therefore, we will not be able to speak the truth.
That's right.
And there will be everybody, the world will be deceived. We're not having it because the Most High has his own way of working. And what happened is we already got the first two transcripts of the pretrial. I don't have them. Other people got them. The attorney don't have them. Other people got them because they say only the attorney can get it. And that means only the attorney can look at it, only the attorney can check it out. But we have several attorneys.
Right.
We don't have one attorney. That's what they think, there's only one attorney.
Right.
But we already got two very important, though they're pre-trial, they're the 30th and the 16th in detail. And as our experts are going through them, there's so many contradictions and mistakes that alone is going to further heighten an investigation into the illegalness and corruptness of this particular case.
Hmm.
If all of that went too fast for you.
No, not at all. I caught all that. Well, basically, at this point, they're trying to...
Oh, by the way, also the suit that I have for torture.
Right.
They were trying to let us go to a limitation so we would miss that by giving us a deadline, but we made that too. That's in, so the torture suit goes on. And that's not just a national suit, that's an international suit. It's in the United Nations, it's in Geneva, it's in Belgium. I mean, we made it a worldwide thing. Everybody has documents in their hand of it, so it doesn't stay in Middle Georgia in the small mines that rule this area through old primitive racism.
Right. And at this point in it, we're going into the sentencing phase of things.
Right.
What do you see that they're trying so hard to do at this point to keep the truth from coming out besides just the closing of the minutes and things of that nature?
Okay, what they did was very interesting. They never expected us to be able to respond to their PSI the way we did with all the experts. They was dependent on us using one person.
Mm-hmm.
But we fooled them, and we responded to everything that they have. They saw that, and they panicked. So now that's what made them come down with, let's close it down. So in attempt, they send a document out saying they want to add some more witnesses into the federal PSI.
Mm-hmm.
And they didn't know on the same day we was found the answer to the PSI.
Mm-hmm.
If I'm trying to say,
yeah.
Now what they got to do is fool the public by rushing into a sentence, make like they don't see none of this stuff, put it off, let the judge sit up there. He has to address a certain thing in a certain period of time by the 23rd, which we can't discuss right now,
mm-hmm.
right? But then knock all that down and then go on to their sentence. Give me a sentence to the public, broadcast it all over the television, make it look like Malachi got sentenced, and all that stuff, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And then hide it when we come after him, and the public won't hear it, because the media down here, of course, Middle Georgia, Megan Telegraph, Channel 13, Channel, whatever, it's 20-something, all of them are part of the good old boy circle. So they
right.
keep it locked down on what they want. They only put on television down here what they want, the program they want, and the media that they control every day is only local. So that people down here will never know what happened. I'll be out here somewhere, to, you know, in a federal place somewhere while we overturn this case, and the public will never hear it, they think.
Right.
But because we're public people, we're literate people, we're going to make sure everything we do goes up on the internet.
Okay.
And we're going to get the transcripts, even if you close it, because we're going to file what they call the Sunshine Act.
Right.
The Freedom of Information Act. He's locking all these things down because he don't want the public to hear what went on in pre-trial discussions. I forgot what day that was when I was down in his office. He seals it anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, we got some of them. Some of them he seals. Everything that can be deprimentary to him, where he's contradicting himself, or where he's being biased, or where he's outright violating the law, he's locking away and sealing down so the public can't see it. But there's laws in this country that mean, called the sun, like I called the Sunshine Act, like I said, which gives you the right to file. It's like the stenographer who can block it down. The stenographer tells our brothers today, right, that, well, he's not going to continue because he heard that they're going to lie. How do you hear? Who told him? Somebody had to call over and tell the man who actually is supposed to be doing the transcripts. And that's before the judge have even stamped it.
Right.
Or approved it. So that means they're so in cahoots that they're all calling each other saying, stop these people from getting these transcripts. now, they heard by listening to my telephone calls and transporting them to each other that we already got two major dates. We got the 30th and we got the 16th, right? Not to mention we got other motions where the judge moved on jurisdiction, which he had no authority to do, nor did he answer it properly. But we got the ones where we made points of jurisdiction and we made points of age dealing with a certain individual where we caught their indictment when the indictment was incorrectly written. We had an attorney working with us called Ben Davis, right? And he had trapped Moultrie, and the court came to Moultrie's aid. But first the judge said, I'm going to have to go with Mr. Ben Davis, Mr. Moultrie. I'm going to have to go with Mr. Ben Davis because what he's saying is factual. Then the judge gave Moultrie a chance to come up with something. We checked the dockets. There's no docket where Moultrie ever responded to that, and they went on with the trial anyway. So they have so many things and so many ways that they violated the law in this case that they've done it themselves. Now they got to try to hoodwink you. But the sun is coming in. The sun is coming out. Our people will be out. We're going to have signs. We're going to be marching. We don't violate the law, and we're nonviolent. Mm-hmm. But we will be marching, and we will have signs, and we will bring from across the state. There are absolute thousands of them out there marching signs until we get a reaction on all these violations. This is a corrupt case. It's bogus. You know what I'm saying? I'm innocent of these charges. They know I am. I've written 407 books. I scared the living heck out of these people because I'm so literate and on the growth of this organization. And then on top of that, our tribe. I am not the leader of all the Nuwapians. I am the chief of the Yamasee Native American Moors of the Creek Nation, which also, by the way, comes up in the minutes for the 30th, right? And confirms it, all those confirmations. You follow? But
right.
They want to make me the leader so they can do this kingpin thing and do this RICO thing, which they don't have any legitimacy to it.
Right.
They're just trying to override the people with their self-righteousness. Think because they say it, you must believe it. That's the whole slave master mentality. Just because somebody there who's a European says it, it must be believed.
Right.
And that's why they did everything to block the evidence in the court. And now that the public didn't get a chance to see it with their own eyes, which violated my Sixth Amendment right and the First Amendment right, right? Now they're going to make it so you can't even hear it. So they can go on and try to do what they want. We're too many of us. We're too powerful of a people. We're too dedicated to what we're about. And we're not the kind of niggas they bred.
Right.
By far. They will have to reckon with us. We will deal. We don't do violence, but we will make the world know. And it's growing every day.
Well, thank you again for taking another time out.
My pleasure.
All right.
The truth shall make you free.
That's right.
All right.
Take care.